How's it going, everybody? This is Tech Literate. My name is Nick, and today I want to look at some benchmarking. So there is a huge list of softwares that you can find to benchmark your CPU. So there's like 3DMark, Blender Benchmark, Cinebench, Geekbench, NovaBench, Passmark, RealBench, Software Sandra, Unigen Suite, User Benchmark, and those are just 10 of them, and there's plenty more. I have chosen to go with one of the simplest and most widely used benchmarking softwares, which is Cinebench. It renders an image to evaluate the CPU's real-world performance, and once it's finished, the test gives you a score which can be compared to the performance of other chips or even your own chip after doing some overclocking. And the best part, it's really simple. It's like super easy to use, and that's why I like it. So first, go ahead to maxon.net/en/, and right here there's a drop down for products, and you just want to go down to Cinebench R20. And you have two options here from Microsoft Store. Don't do it. Microsoft Store is hot garbage. Yes, it is. And the App Store if you're on Mac. But I like to download directly from Maxon. That's easiest for me. So if you scroll down to Cinebench R20 here, click down there, and you want to get the second one, Cinebench R20 for Windows. Hit the download, and that's going to give you this download here. So once it's finished downloading, you're gonna have this zip file here. You can just right click it, extract all. If you have another program to unzip it, that's fine too. But you can just use the Windows extractor. Now once it's extracted, you can just open up the Cinebench R20 folder and you can delete the zip file. And you don't have to install it. It's just already ready to go. So you can just launch Cinebench by double clicking on the exe file. And now it's open. So all you have to do is press run. That's it. We'll go through more of the stuff now, but I'm just gonna go ahead and run the software and speed up the video so you can see what it looks like. All right, and it's finished. So it gave us a score right here, 4648, and you can see right above it is another AMD Ryzen 7 3700X, and that's actually my test. So it'll keep your best test if you want it to. There's a little checkbox here up in file, keep best score. Now, the reason why I got a lower score this time is probably because I'm using OBS right now and actually recording the screen. And I might have been doing a little bit of mild overclocking to get that score earlier today. But anyways, here's a list of some other CPUs to compare yours to. Now, these are a bit outdated, but you can actually download files from other users online, and you can just put them into the file folder here. CB ranking, and that'll input them into the application. So you can see mine is better than the one listed here, Ryzen 7 1700X, and below the Ryzen Threadripper, at least in this list, but it didn't perform too badly. I think that's pretty good. So what really is useful with this is, like I said, if you're doing overclocking, you can absolutely use this as your benchmark, and it's really easy to use. Like I said, just click run. But it is the year 2020, and games, unfortunately, still only use a single processor for the most part. So if you go here to File, there's this box here, Advanced Benchmark. Click that, and it's going to give you an extra option, which is Single Core. You can hit Run, and it's going to give you a score again, but it's only going to be using one of your processors within your CPU, and it's going to take a lot longer than the original one. I don't want to do that right now, but I'm going to. Here we go. As you can see, this benchmark here, as opposed to the other one, the single core one, it's only rendering one of those boxes at a time. So it's gonna take a lot longer. So I'm gonna have to go do something and wait while this finishes. Okay, and there is our score. We have 495 points for this single core test. And as you can see in this list here, it is at the top of the list. But that being said, these are all outdated chips. Like this Core i7-7700K. 7700K, excuse me. What is that, like 3-4 years old at this point? So it's performed well. I mean, it's doing good. Ryzen's not known to be the absolute best for single core. It's more about the multi-core function with Ryzen, at least at this point. We'll see what happens next month. But anyways, that's basically Cinebench. Cinebench. That's basically Cinebench. And if you want to use it, it's free to use, easy to download. I'm going to give a little bit more of a tour. It won't take long because there's not very much to look at. So the first options we have here under File is Keep Best Score, Advanced Benchmark. That's like I showed you just a moment ago to get you that CPU single core. Run All Selected Tests. That'll run both the tests. And Preferences, which there are only a couple here, which you can customize the number of threads you want to use to render the image. So I can do less than 16. 16 is obviously my maximum, because that's what my CPU has. And you can make what the minimum test duration is. So if you have a chip that's really fast, you can change that. So coming down from here, it has my system, which tells me what my processor is, how many cores and threads it has, the clock speed, my operating system, and what my GPU is. Down here in the ranking, you can decide on what details you want to be shown, and that's gonna show up in one line. So if I were to add, like for example, OS, it's just gonna extend that information. And up here, you can choose the CPU, so that's the entire CPU, like we had that test before, single core, and the MP ratio. So that ratio is basically, the higher the ratio, the bigger multi-core performance it has. That's it. So yeah, that's Cinebench. It's free and easy to use. You can find it at maxon.net. I'll have it in the video description down there. This has been Tech Illiterate. Hope you enjoyed it. Remember, you know, like, subscribe, comment, do all the stuff. Really appreciate it, guys. Thanks for watching. My name's Nick. See you later.